We live in an age of technology in which machines touch every part of our lives. It is not surprising that music has also been influenced by technology. We are listening to music in which every sound was created electronically.
The piece of electronic jazz we are now hearing, which I wrote about a year ago, represents one kind of electronic music. But the range of possibilities is enormous, extending from popular rock and roll settings to the most abstract kind of concert hall music. One of the things that I enjoy most about electronic music is its immediacy. The composer normally waits quite a long time between the time he puts notes on paper and hears his piece performed in a concert hall. But a composer working with electronic music is more like a painter or a sculptor who works directly with his medium. You hear the sounds as they are created. Another challenging part of electronic music is working with sophisticated electronic equipment, such as computers or electronic sound synthesizers.
Ultimately, our machines will match and exceed human intelligence, no matter how one cares to define or measure this elusive term.
Again, if we find this notion troublesome, a lot of this uneasiness has to do with our concept of the word machine. Keep in mind that our concept of this word will evolve along with our minds.
I turned to electronic music mainly because I found I couldn't get the kinds of sounds I wanted with live players and ordinary instruments. I wanted very fast running passages and complicated rhythms which players can't perform. I wanted pitches which lie in between the pitches of the regular instruments. And I wanted particularly sound qualities which no instrument or combination of instruments can readily produce. One of the consequences of the new types of sound is that the old notation using notes on staffs simply doesn't work anymore. We find that we have to introduce an entirely new sort of notation which often takes the form of graphs.
What is it?
I know you're good, but still, I mean, you're all alone here now.
Grattan!
I think this old house is gonna become your tomb!
We'll be right back. I often find that as a composer, my ears are very, very highly tuned to just ordinary sounds. I can remember once at a friend's place, which was in a back section. It was in the suburbs. And all the houses around, there were about eight of them, they were all doing the lawns. And there were sounds of about eight lawnmowers all around. And as they went round different sides of the house, they came closer and further away. And it really gave a very, very nice effect. I tried to repeat it again on tape, but it didn't work quite as well. So in actual fact, there are often really good pieces in everyday existence if one just listens to them in the right way.
The film you're about to see has no characters. If you spare a little of your imagination, it is a film to describe to you the effect of cymatic frequencies on matter.
Thank you.
everything owes its existence solely and completely to sound.
Thank you.
My type of music doesn't involve melodies and tonal implications like the music of the past does, but it's more to the timbre of the of sounds. It's really just basically the sounds which I find interesting, and I make it music by organising those sounds in a set pattern. Sounds, weird sounds some people call them, but what I think are interesting sounds, I try and mold them into a structure, and I often found that the quality of the sounds and the sounds themselves dictate what the structure should be.
Drop the kids off and go party, gets me mad. So I pray, pray for peace and pray for change. Keep on praying when everything stays the same. And I pray for the pastors and all of the churches and those who cry nights on following hearses. I pray for you, pray for the sick and the poor. Pray for the rich man who don't give to the Lord. And I pray for wisdom and I pray for power. And I pray for be ready in the final hour. And I pray for those who keep judging ministry. And I pray for my friends and my enemies.
Where I am, Can somebody help me up? Who?
I was talking to a group of people one day, and most of them were really into it. They're all fine art students, and they really, really appreciated what I was trying to get into. However, there were a couple of others who sort of said, will it ever be over Radio Avon? Do you ever envisage your music on Radio Avon? And I suppose the answer is really no. I mean, I can't see my type of music going on Radio Avon or any other radio, merely because it's inaccessible. I think the rest is up to the people who listen to it.
The computer, built into the modern digital sound synthesizer, makes it possible for the musician to compose pieces quickly. By using a light pen, the composer is telling the computer what pre-recorded sounds he wants to use. He can easily add or subtract instruments, pitches, and rhythms. Of synthesizers and computers, it is possible to imitate, change, and create sound. A whole new world of creative possibilities has been opened to the musician by electronic music.
common with all other art, electronic music also has its aesthetics. It is, of course, impossible to distinguish clearly between aesthetics and style, and as a result of this, I shall treat the two concepts as synonymous from here onwards. Electronic music is still in its infancy, being only 20 years old, and it is difficult to orientate its aesthetics with any degree of certainty at this present stage. We shall, however, try to deal with five different forms of aesthetics. They range from elegance to surrealistic grotesqueness. Before we go into the finer nuances of style and aesthetics, it wouldn't be a bad idea to use some of the electronic material which we have worked with previously. We can try to achieve different articulations with this in small experiments before we survey it in the context of a larger pattern. We shall use three different types of material in these attempts: A, B, and C. The material can change character according to the mode of treatment. Here you hear material A in one of its forms. Have a look at the score, example 13. In the same way as material A, material B can vary somewhat within its own category of sonority. See example 41. And in one of its versions, it sounds like this. Material C is based on the now famous word Jacob, as you will clearly be able to hear. It was the word used by the Dane rather than Paulson at the time when he conducted his epoch-making experiments, which led to the invention of the tape recorder. See example 32. We now try to achieve different formulations with material A, B, and C. The two first examples show the difference between monopoly and change. Both examples are based on the same type of material, A. Example 33 in the score shows an impulse to a square tone. Monopoly stems quite simply from the almost brutal regularity with which the speed of the impulses needs to be increased and diminished. Furthermore, the same note at the same dynamic level is used the whole time. Example 34 in the score also uses impulse chopped square tones. The variety in this example comes from the alteration in the tone brought about by a more nuanced alternation in the speed of the impulses and by vigorous dynamics. Now we shall listen to material A, respectively a monotonous and a changing version. See examples 33 and 34.
This material is now made more complicated in example 36 by my mixing example 35 at various speeds on track 1 and then using the phonogen. The result is combined 4 times in 4 different ways, as can be seen in the score. This recording is called Y. In the score, Y without reverberation is denoted by an unbroken line, and Y with reverberation is denoted by a dotted line. On track 2, we put an almost compact interwoven mesh of sine waves, which are composed of haphazard glissandos in a certain frequency area. The envelopes can be seen in the score. It can sound like this, for example. After that, we'll try combining material A, B, and C. Track 2. In the previous example, Track 2. We put an almost compact interwoven mesh of sine waves. Track 2. We put an almost compact interwoven mesh of sine waves. Track 2. We put an almost compact interwoven mesh of sine waves. Track 2. We put an almost compact interwoven mesh of sine waves. Track 2. In the previous example, we used, of course, only material A. Track 2. First of all, we arrange the material. See the score of example 37, 38. Note that example 37 is 6 seconds long, example 38 lasts 5 seconds, and example 39 only 4 seconds. And now listen to the three parts. After this, the experiments will consist of putting A, B, and C after each other and on top of each other. This successive method needs no explanation other than what is given in example 14 in the score. Here is example 14. Two concepts are synonymous from here onwards.